I don't know of a private company regularly evaluating anything, or I don't know of a you don't have to get sinkhole insurance here, so there's not been
something that should change.
It will change, but even after you have that sort of study done, you know, there's better and worse. If you just come out with a take like five soil cores in 50 acres or something like that, probably don't know enough to say it's safe. But what I see of construction here, a lot of times these engineering companies kind of go on the bottom, and they're just going to screw everything off down to what's the but there is real bedrock, but they're going to strip it off of what's the hardest stuff, and so they never really figure out the drainage or anything. They just assume they're going to strip it off, and but then I'm sure we had the issue with the parking lot here. I don't know exactly, because but one of my students was working for the engineering company, same engineering. There's basically only like a few engineering companies here, and I'm sure they're not that bad. There's not that much competition, and they're just used to doing fairly cursory stuff. But it was sort of this gray clay stuff that I think the foundation started to sort of rock a little bit after they put it down. They had the
and of course, that Moody Housing federal housing project has a sinkhole on the property,
right?
And is in aquifer recharge zone,
right?
There's another organization in the room, Students Against Violating the Environment, which there's the president, right? Daniel Gordon. Perhaps you'd like to say something about the city.